Hi everybody, my name is Dakota Bell and this is Red Shadow Forge. Today, we're going to be forging a knife using 5160. We're going to be using an anthracite coal forge, so if you stick around, we'll show you getting that started up. This is going to be the first of hopefully many YouTube series videos. So stick around and we'll show you how it's done.
In some anthracite coal to our forge. A lot of other blacksmiths and bladesmiths use either a propane forge or sometimes they use different types of coal. We choose to use anthracite. We like the way it burns. It's inexpensive.
So it takes a while to heat up, which is why when we start the forge up originally, we use
chopped up pieces of wood, let those coals burn in there for a little while, then we add the anthracite. Let that heat up for a while. Once it gets to that bright yellow and that color that you want, then we can put our steam in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the 5160 built that I have. I'm going to put that in, let it heat up for a while, and then I'm going to normalize it a few times. So I'm just going to pull it out into the ambient temperature and let it cool down. Once it's cooled down, I'll put it back in. Do the same thing, probably about 3, maybe 4 times, probably maybe just twice. But we're going to do that. And what that does is it makes it a little bit easier for me to hammer it into the shape that I want to make a knife in. It's very hard steel, so when I put it in the forge without normalizing it first, it takes a lot longer to get into the shape that I want. So I'm going to normalize it twice, and then we're going to continue the videos, and you'll actually get to see me hammering and using this railroad track anchor and making it into the shape of the knife.
And we'll do the rest of the steps. You'll see all that stuff as we get done.
Kurt. So I've normalized this twice. That'll make it a little bit easier for me to manipulate with the hammer. Let it heat up, get the core out. Try to start working on the tip.
With this kind of steel, you don't want to hit it too much once it starts to lose its color. It's a little hard to tell in the daytime, but
just that little bit of hammering I was able to do,
which isn't much, however, it's significantly more than I would have been able to do if I didn't normalize it. So
it makes it a lot more easier.
Which is what I want.
So I'm gonna do this enough times where I feel that the tip is in the shape that I want. Then I'm gonna start working on the tank here. I'll heat up the tang a little bit where I want it, and then I'll make a step in it so that I can start working on the tang to separate that from the lid. This stuff with the anthracite coal does not take long to heat up, which I really like. You just have to be careful. When I first started doing this, using railroad spikes and things like that, even with some of the 5160 billets that I've tried making out of before, I've melted some of the tips off of it. Because as you see, it doesn't take long.
It's under a minute,
especially if you're just heating up the tip of it like I am right now so that I can get the tip in the shape that I want. It really doesn't take long.
I'll make sure that it's got that bright color to it with the hammer.
You don't want to crack the steel.
That was about 20 seconds, if that. So this really does not take long to heat up.
So there's a little, if you look, it might be a little hard to see, there's a right in here, so at the very tip of this, there's a tiny little, almost fold. That's not that deep, so it could be taken care of, which is good. If it were too deep and we continued to do this, it would just generate a big crack, and we don't want to do that. So I'll still be able to use this. It's not that big of a deal because we do have a grinder. So that can be taken care of. It's not that big of a deal. Just that is something you want to look out for when you're hammering your tip in, especially with this 5060. I've done it quite a few times. If you put a fold in, you're going to create that little fissure. And definitely might be junk glue. You don't want to put that in there. So, I'm not too worried about it right now. Just going to let it be. I'd like to take care of the grinder, like I said. But I'm going to try to bring that tip in a little bit more. Leave that alone for a minute. I'm gonna come down here, drop back, drop my hammer as well. Drop back to probably right about here, and then I'm going to set it on the edge of the anvil and hammer it down so I can make a little step in there so that I can start working on the tang. And I think I am gonna do a slightly rounded tang on this. So it makes it easier with the train track anvil that we're using. Already got a nice curve to the top. Try to keep the tip out of the hottest part of the coals and move it forward to where I can heat up the tank for. So it's going to take just a little bit longer than it was to heat up the tip because that had already been heated up quite a bit. So this will take a little bit longer. Step right there. That's where I know my blade is going to stop and my tang is going to start. So I'm going to go ahead and now try to heat this up so that I can start working on the tip. Yep. So I gotta straighten it out quite a bit because it's getting pretty messed up. But once I get done doing that, I'll go back to shaping up the tang a little bit more. I just don't want it to be too warped or crooked. So I think I'm going to stop there for now. What I'm going to do next is try to heat this portion right here up so I can hot cut it. Once I do that, I'll have more ability to manipulate it with the tongs. Be able to hold it a little bit easier. And then I will try to put the bevel in the blade side and go from there.
I'm going to try to make this arch stand out a little bit more and tang.
Now I'm going to flip it back over and I'm going to work on this tip again a little bit more.
So I've decided what I'm going to try to do with this extreme point on this. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave that alone for now. And I'm going to start hammering in the bevels of the edge. Try to see if it can push some of the steel this way. And then I'll see what I can do with that once I'm a little bit thinner on the sides.
Alright, so I'm done with the forge for now. This is the shape that we got out of that 5160 knife that I was working on. I took it to the grinder a little bit to try to get that ridiculous tip off. And now we've just got this very curved blade and the curved tang on as well. I'm gonna go ahead and set this down for the day and maybe take a look at it and try to figure out what I can do with it or if I'm gonna keep the shape. It's not what I was going for, but it's still a good knife shape on it. So I set this to the side, take it to the drawing table a little bit, try to decide what to do with it. So we're going to do some other stuff. Not quite sure exactly what yet, but I'll get back to you. We'll have some more. So, thanks for watching.